2 years after a similar clandestine mission, China launched a highly classified reusable experimental spacecraft into orbit. On August 4th, a Long March 2F rocket took off from the Jiuquan Satellite Launch Center in the Gobi Desert, sending a reusable test space into low Earth orbit. Chinese state media Xinhua confirmed the successful launch around 3 hours after the 12 p.m. Eastern opening of a launch window. The test spacecraft is supposed to operate in orbit for a certain period before returning to its intended site in China. Technical verification of reusable and in-orbit services will be performed as planned to provide technical support for the peaceful use of space. The rumors specify that Chinese commercial firm Space Transportation is raising funds for its hypersonic spaceplane plans. Stay till the end to find out how China is using space for military purposes. Welcome back to Liftoff, where we tell you the latest news and information regarding Elon Musk and his top-notch companies, space news, and rocket launches. Before we begin, make sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon so you never miss any of our future updates. The Long March 2F is basically a mystery vehicle and is thought to be a robotic space plane. It's said to be roughly the same size as the U.S. Space Force's X-37B, based on Long March's 2F's considerable payload capacity. China also launched a reusable test spacecraft in September 2020 and didn't specify much about that mission either. The space vehicle that was used almost 2 years ago stayed in space for 2 days and released a small payload in orbit before coming down for a landing in China. It may or may not be the same one that lifted off on Thursday. The X-37B spaceplane has been orbiting Earth for more than 800 days on its latest mystery mission, the sixth for the X-37B program. The Space Force has a strong fleet, including two 29-foot-long spaceplanes built by Boeing. The Long March 2F was launched on a busy day in spaceflight. On that day, six rockets were launched worldwide from different places. It started with Rocket Lab's lofting of a spy satellite for the U.S. National Reconnaissance Office at 1 a.m. Eastern Time. Moreover, on August 4, a United Launch Alliance Atlas V launched a missile warning satellite for the Space Force, and Blue Origin sent six people to suborbital space. On the other hand, China launched a TSIS-1 Earth observation satellite, and Korea's Danuri moon probe lifted on top of a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. So did you know this spacecraft was tracked by the Space Force's 18th Space Defense Squadron? 18 SDS tracked the spacecraft in a 346 by 593 kilometer orbit inclined by 50 degrees. Usually, the space authorities release information or images related to their space ventures, but China's space authorities have not released any images of the launch or related operations. They didn't even share images from a similar profile mission launched in 2020. While there isn't much information about the spacecraft, many have given their opinion based on previous statements and activities that the vehicle is a kind of space plane. It may look somewhat like an orbital segment that will operate with a reusable suborbital stage that was apparently tested in 2021. The latter involved a vertical takeoff and horizontal landing. The Long March 2F rocket was mainly used for China's Shenzhou crewed missions. This rocket has a perfect payload capacity of over 8 metric tons to low Earth orbit, which suggests that the spacecraft may have the same functions and size as the U.S. Air Force's X-37B spaceplane. The Long March 2F and its payload capacity may have been increased to accommodate the launch of a reusable test spacecraft. As far as the body of this rocket is concerned, it is similar to the Long March 2E, but why? The Long March 2F is actually a derivative of the Long March 2E. Most of the changes in the latest rocket involve the addition of redundant systems to improve safety, although some structural modifications allow the rocket to support the heavier capacity required by the Shenzhou capsule. This rocket is also capable of lifting heavier payloads with some extra space for boosters to the first stage. There are several built-in options in the rocket, such as an advanced fault monitoring and diagnosis system, to help the astronauts escape in time of emergency. This means that the rocket has a launch escape system, and it will be the first Chinese-made rocket to be assembled and rolled out to its launch site vertically. Another derivative, called the Long March 2F/G, was launched back in 2011, and it was designed to launch space laboratories such as Tiangong-1 and Tiangong-2. Besides, it dispenses with the launch escape system and supports a larger capacity to accommodate the bulkier payloads. If we talk about China's previous orbital test of a reusable experimental spacecraft that took place in September 2020, the spacecraft spent just under 2 days in orbit, and after that, it released a small payload before landing in China. Although China has not specified any information regarding the subject, it seems like this project will fit in perfectly with the space transportation development plans outlined by CASC, China's main space contractor, and its major subsidiaries. In the past, CASC also iterated plans to develop low-cost, reliable access to space, including reusable launch vehicles and space planes. A white paper is released by the State Council Information Office every 5 years. It was released in January 2022, in which China said, to continue to strengthen research into key technologies for reusable space transport systems and conduct test flights accordingly. Chen Hongbo from CASC's China Academy of Launch Vehicle Technology, or CALT, said to Science and Technology Daily Chinese in 2017 that a reusable spacecraft is under development process, which would be capable of carrying both crew and payloads. He also mentioned that they will test it in 2020. A veteran chief designer of the Long March rocket series, Long Lei Hao, presented a range of space transportation concepts during a public lecture last month, including a space plane render. Bledon Bowen of the University of Leicester told Space News that in case China opts to work on such a project, they will only face huge technological and other challenges. He said, space planes and reusable orbital vehicles have come and gone and come back again. There can be some marginal and varied uses for them, but they are extremely expensive compared to conventional rockets because of the stresses of atmospheric re-entry wreak havoc on the materials and the structures. Bowen also said that Chinese development of space plane technology will be remarkable if they manage to overcome the problems Dinosaur and the Space Shuttle faced, and the challenges SpaceX's Starship are now facing as well. He mentioned that we should see space plane development as part of China's wider investments in all manner of space technologies, civilian and military, and not as something uniquely threatening or certain to succeed where others have failed. China is also considering some other reusable spacecraft or space plane projects. The China Aerospace Science and Industry Corp, or CASIC, or CASIC, is another massive state-owned enterprise that is working on its space plane with its name Tengyun. Zhang Hongwen from CASIC told CCTV in 2018 that, unlike rocket recycling adopted by SpaceX, the space plane can take off from an ordinary airport to transport spacecraft into orbit. It will bring about a revolution for future space transportation. Chinese commercial firm Space Transportation is raising funds for its hypersonic planes, and they raised more than $46.3 million last year. On the other hand, the US X-37B space plane is currently carrying out its sixth mission, which has already extended to more than 800 days in orbit. Additional plans were revealed by CALT to develop a fully reusable super heavy lift launch vehicle over the next decade, because they were apparently inspired by the SpaceX Starship project. In October 2021, an article was published by the Financial Times that was entitled China's Test of New Space Capability with a Hypersonic Missile in August. They suggested that China is most likely using the space for military purposes, and in response, the Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson Zhao Lijian said the test mentioned in the Financial Times report was in fact a routine test of technology for reusing a space vehicle. He seemed very interested in the gossip and stated that such a test is meant to lower the cost of using a space vehicle, and it can provide more low-cost measures for the peaceful use of space. Do tell us your views in the comment section about the possibilities of success of the Long March 2F rocket. And if you've reached this far, like this video, subscribe to our channel, and press the notification bell so you don't miss any future updates. I'll see you in another video. Until then, take care.